Fear the Power of the Sun is welcome to another Let's Play GT3 video. And we're going to be doing races 3 and 4 in this part. But before I get started, please be sure to watch the video, burn up that like button, destroy that subscribe button, speed through that notification bell, leave a good comment down below, follow me on Twitter for great snaze. Check out Blue Vivacity and Sonic Central, their YouTube links are description as always. And if you guys are new to this channel, be sure to everything I just said. It helps out a lot, and I just appreciate the support and feedback. We are on to race 3, and we're on the halfway point of the championship, so, yeah, let's go. It's, welcome to Route 11. Reverse. We haven't gotten to this track yet. So, welcome to Route 11. A hated track by many people. Now you'll get to see what Route 11 is like and what its difficulty is like. And as I said in the last part, this is the most difficult race in this 5-race championship, so we're just gonna have to bear probably with me being in a low position for a little bit. And expect me to suck here. This track is featured in a lot of different series in this game. Like, a lot. Which one's the real Silver Clio? Clearly the one in Petsworth. I want to gain at least one spot before the end of this first lap. Because their pitting here is different than the first two races. Trying to keep fourth. Nope, nope, nope. I get put and walked. Yeah, and by the way, going forwards is just as bad as going the reverse direction. Okay, well, this is a wonderful start, but like I said, I'm probably going to be in a low position for a little bit until my tires warm up. Thankfully, I'm in slipstream range, so I can just slipstream off this Clio and not really lose a whole lot of time. I didn't really lose much time, which is a plus. You can see laps are much longer here than Grand Valley. And you'll know when their tires wear out, too. Like, you'll feel a sudden change in the swing of the races. Oh, 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 going on the inside, and I have now claimed fifth. Yay! I finally have my first position. Yeah, I wonder why. It's because my tires are long enough. Well, at least I'm in front of you. It's that blue one I need to worry about. Even though there's a tie for second in points, these gray ones are not letting it easy for me. I mean silver. Iceberg silver. Not gray. Oh, to take third. Nope, I'm gonna keep it safe. I don't want to lose my fourth place. But I on my way. Wait, doing that. Seems like these Cleos don't like me here. Well, if you don't like me, then I'll just slipstream off this blue one. And not really lose any time. Lost maybe about a tenth of a second. Oh well, it's not that big of a deal. I'll be fine. As long as I don't screw this turn up. That chicane can go screw itself. Is catching these two. I mean, come on, one of these guys is in fifth in points. Why is he up here? Well, blue one's looking to pass me again. And he's not going to. Unless they do something stupid, which is highly likely. I just need to drive well. There's no way I'm gonna get the lead on the track, so I'm just gonna have to drive my butt off and stay as close as I can. You like to have that magic number. But your magic number here is... Well, knowing this track is difficult, the most difficult track in the game, you probably wanna be within 15 seconds of them to be at least a little safe. They do a pretty bad job. And would you look at that, I'm right there. See, just took time that I needed. I kept it off the wall and I kept second. That was good. That was a good pass. I mean, they're not as stupid here on the reverse course, but they are very dumb on the forward course, the opposite direction. Go for the lead. Nope, not gonna hold it. Go, oh my gosh, that was good. Got a good run out of there. Oh, I am not gonna like this. Ha ha, you hit the wall. Stupid. Guys are enjoying this championship so far. This being the halfway race. Ooh, that was a good turn. Choo-choo-choo. also the colorful Ferris wheel of colorfulness. Gotta love it. Am I going to, I don't know about my space on my phone that I have, how much it will benefit me for them races being very long. The races in the Polyphony Digital Cup are 20 laps each, so one race, 20 laps, usually about 40 minutes. Some courses it's more, which would mean that Route 11 and Grand Valley Reverse are going to need backup videos. We're going to need the second part. Most likely. But when I did this the last time, they didn't go over 46 minutes. Route 11 barely didn't need it. But Grand Valley didn't have that issue. Yeah, I'm pulling away. They're gonna have to pit. Should be no way I'm gaining this much time. Oh, yeah. Oh, I was hoping that was going to put a B at Dobgod. The 4 and 3 would swap, so it would say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I was hoping it would say something like that, but not by much. There's the Ferris wheel. 2 laps to go. Yeah, here we go. Here's the odd pitting. 2 of the Clios go in. Two of them. This song is my favorite song in the entire game. Can't Stop the Rock. I knew this championship was going to test my phone battery capabilities to see how it would handle. And I'm thinking it's holding up pretty well. Hope it is. And there goes the other three. Really looks like the Golden Gate Bridge for some reason. I don't know why, but it just does. Even though the Golden Gate Bridge is not blue, it's red. And that could be Route X over there. Or no, Route 7. So now you know where the difficultiness of this track comes in. AI are not very nice here, and they suck. They do. Just wait till we get to the forward, the opposite direction when we go the forward direction. The correct, proper direction. Just wait. And there you have it. 38 seconds for Route 11. The next race will not take very long. At least it shouldn't. So there you go. We got a tie for fourth again. And we've split the tie for second. Back up to where we were. On to race four. Which will be the shortest race of the championship. Deep Forest. Oh yeah, I never really explained the tire wear stuff. Yeah. Even though I think I already explained it, but I'll just explain it again. Basically, blue tires is your cold tires, your like lime to green, your green to lime color is basically your highest grip, and orange and red are your worst grip possible. Therefore, that's why the pits exist. So you can go in, change your tires, get a fresh set, and go on with whatever race you're doing. And they only show up in the races that have 5 or more laps, except the rally ones. Because while rally, there is no tire wear. So yeah, they each go to a different color. I love taking this turn flat out every time. So I thought this race was the shortest one. Thank you. I wish I could do an LP on GT4, but again, championships, endurances, some of them are way too long for my phone to handle. I think this game is good enough. I don't really need to stretch out to GT4. Except the GT4 arcade series that is almost finished. Because I had mad skills in the 80s sports car cup. Which, if you missed that part, holy crap, that last race was very good and challenging. So if I can do this championship, then all the other 5 race championships are doable. And this will include that Dream Car Championship as well. No. Only in the Amateur League, though. But we haven't gotten to the really long stuff yet. Just wait. We'll get there. Kinda gotta get through the Beginner League first. Which actually, after this championship, we can set sail through the finish of the Beginner League. Because we'll have the Beetle Cup car. We can do the GT World Championship if I want to. And I have enough money to at least buy one car for each series left in the Beginner League. Well, except for Mercedes-Benz, but you get the idea. But you know what series I'll be doing next, which will be the Beetle Cup. This championship, like all the other 5 and the 7 and the 10 race championships for the amateur and professional league. When we do the 5 race ones, I'll put amateur league twice, like for the first part, and then for the second part, I'll basically put Let's Play Gran Turismo, whatever part it is, and then I'll put amateur league for the first part of, say, the GT World Championship in the Amateur League. And then once I get to race 6 through race 10, then I'll put Amateur League again, but instead of races 1 through 5, I'll put races 6 through 10. So, yeah, that's how that'll work. This race is about the same length as Rome Circuit, which would have been the first race. If you really want to know how well to play this game, just watch these videos and just follow my lines. And just watch how I take these turns in whatever car I use. Or you can use a different car of your choice. You don't have to follow along and use the same car as I do, but if you're playing Gran Turismo or anything and you need a line to figure out for a track, you know, come to these videos. I mean, I'm pretty sure that basically taking the lines that I take will help assist you on being more successful on the track. Whether it's from GT3, GT4, GT5, GT6, GT Sport, these videos will have you covered. Well, I used to do GT Sport videos, but I don't really do that anymore. I wanted to do like a GT5 arcade series and a GT6 arcade series, but that would be way too difficult, way too long. There's way more races in those two games than there are in this game and GT4. So it would be a bit difficult to pull off. Actually, I don't think there's as many tracks in GT6 as there is in GT4, but most of them is just weather change. In GT5 and 6, so things are different. I had tried hooking the PS3 up to this TV last year, tried seeing if I could record, and the buttons were stuck, so no, it was impossible. And well, I've had a lot of issues with GT6's loading time, so I've had it crash, I've had it froze, I've had the track go invisible. I've had issues with it. And out of the exit of the final turn, and there's the finish right there. Bam. Just got one more race left to go, and we'll save that for the final part of the championship. So as we wait. And there you have it. 34 seconds. Although they happen to finish very close each race. I think they're getting slowly closer together as each race has been progressing. So we'll see where the points stand, and kind of the same finish as race number one, depending on where everyone else was at in points, the silver ones and the nocturne ones. And we don't have any more ties. And I've won this championship because I'm up by 20 and there's only one race left. So yay! We're going to win our first Professional League Series of the LP. Woohoo. Yep, I'm back up to where I was. So, and the finale of this championship, we will be taking care of the last race. So be sure to stay tuned for that. But please be sure to burn up the like button, destroy that subscribe button, speed through that notification bell, leave a good comment down below, follow me on Twitter, The Great Sneeze, check out my other YouTube videos, I have playlists, check out Blue Five Ball City and Sonic Central, their YouTube links in the description as always. If you guys are new to this channel, appreciate everything I just said. It helps out a lot, and I always appreciate the support and feedback. And with that, the Clio Trophy will be concluding in the next part. So, catch you guys soon.